a day. As a matter of fact, it's been a week. This week I feel has
and we can ride the boogie, share that beat of love. I wanna ride.
Good morning, sweetie gang. Welcome to a new vlog. Today is Wednesday, June 14th, of course, 2023. I have no problems with that date like I do some other dates because today is my sweetie's birthday. But before I get into all of that, let me just introduce myself to any new subbies. Welcome to the gang. My name is Kinshasha Rhodes, aka Sweet Shosh One. This is a lifestyle channel. We talk about everything. And when I say everything, we talk about everything. It's from food, finances, of course, fashion, relationships, DIYs, you name it, we talk about it. We do some cook with me. And you know, nothing is off the table. How about that? So, welcome. So, I'm out here on my deck. I'm sitting here thinking why I'm out here because it may be a little too loud with the cars going by, but anywho, I'm out here because I'm just simply thinking like, okay, so we were going on vacation for Ace's birthday, but due to some family issues, we had to postpone it, right? So then coming forward, I'm thinking like gathering, trying to figure out what else we was gonna do. Then once the vacation got canceled, his schedule, he changes up the schedule. So then that changes up my plans for pretty much the early part of the day, like the morning part. So now I'm sitting here thinking like, what the heck am I gonna do? Because I still haven't really came to a conclusion about what I'm gonna do. We were gonna go, well, I decided that, you know, he said he just wanted to do something just like something super casual, laid back, nothing too crazy because it's Wednesday. So I found a few nice like rooftop restaurants that we could go to and do like a to do something. It's one in particular that I'm thinking about going to. They having like a wind down Wednesday tonight. Nice view, real laid back, but pretty. So I was thinking about going there. I looked at the forecast and now it's saying rain, but the rain is on the earlier side before we get ready to go there. But you know, with rain, you just never know. Then my other dilemma was one of his gifts didn't arrive at Neiman Marcus on time. It was supposed to arrive at the store like within 3 days. Still is not there. And I ordered the item on June 8th. Today is June 14th. So I'm still without that gift, which was the more important gift because I knew it was something that he wanted. So I don't know. It's like, I don't know. I called the store, called customer service, and so on and so on. And they were like, oh, it should arrive in the store today, but then there's no particular time. So it's just like, like really, you know what I'm saying? Like I had a whole like situation today just thinking about what the hell I'm gonna do because he kind of threw me off with his schedule. Then, you know, the trip was what was in plan. But you know, things happen, life be life, and you know, that's why our podcast is called what it's called, Life Be Life. And so you just have to, you know, get through those hurdles and jump, do whatever you need to do to get through them. So I'm not worried about it at this point. I was a little pissed. Not about having to change the situation because it was due to a family matter, but just how things is just playing out for the day. But, you know, nevertheless, it's still early. So who knows what's going to happen. I'm still gonna try to make his day as nice as possible, but we will turn up for his birthday vacation soon. And of course, you know, we're gonna take you guys along with us. So now I'm gonna get up. I'm going to run out to a couple of stores to figure out some things really early. Maybe keep checking my email to see if I get a notification update from Neiman to see if the item is there. And then maybe look at a couple of other things. I don't know. It's real early today. Right now it's like 10, about 10:30, a little bit after 10:30. So I got time, and like it's not cold today, so a rooftop might be cool. You know, I might have to put on something like a sweater or a jacket. But it's like overcast, so we'll see. I don't know. I am a person that likes organization. I do like to plan things. I like to have things organized. I am like very anal about things like that, but I have to have things organized because I wear a lot of hats. I have a lot of different things going on, so I like to be organized and I like to know what I'm doing when I'm doing it, or at least have an idea of what I want to do, you know, to have some options, you know, like I go with the flow, but I'm really not a go with the flow kind of girl because, you know, going with the flow is for dead fish and I'm not a dead fish. So I'm not the kind of go with the flow. I do like options. If I know what the options is, I'm like, all right, let's make it do what it do. But just to like wait and see what happens, nah, I don't see what happens. I make things happen. You know, that's just how I am. So when I don't have anything in order, I don't have things in mind or everything's planned, I don't like things like that. You know, I like to go and then let me know what my options are and then I'll just pick and choose and roll with it. But that's just wait and see. That's not my style. So that's something else new that you guys learned, you know, you learned about me, I guess. Or if you haven't noticed it, and for those that know me, know. But anywho, I am going to throw on my sneakers and I guess head out, okay? So I'll see you guys probably in the car. Hi guys, so I'm back. So the day is turning around a little bit. We have a little sun now, not a lot, but a little. I'll take that, and it's not raining, so that's good. Also, Neiman Marcus called me, well, not called me, emailed me and said my package was ready, so I'm happy about that. Even though it's like 12 noon now, I would have rather been there when they first opened, but I'm not complaining, it's fine. I'll be able to still get to go and pick it up and then like try to get home and then get myself together so I can get ready and get out of the house on time. So we'll see how that goes. I gotta pick up this cake, and like not a big cake, just like a mini cake, and that is about it. And then just see how the rest of the day and the night goes. Like I said, I wish it was something more, but if he's cool with it, I'm good with it too. Also, I was just sitting here talking to my son. He's right here. Can you say hi? You can wave your hands. And he and I was just discussing some of the commentators here on YouTube, and of course some of the podcasts, different things that have spoken so much on what the hell is going on over here? Oh God, look at this traffic. Look what I might have to face coming back. That's gonna be a problem. See, it's going, is not gonna be a problem. Coming back is the problem. Cause the Neiman Marcus that I'm going to is about 30 minutes from me. Oh well. So, back to what I was saying. We was just kind of like discussing some of the videos and things we were looking at on DC Fly and Jackie O's relationship and the surgery and things like that. And it's good to sometimes hear young people's perspective. Sometimes they got more sense than some of these older people and the things that come out of people's mouths. You know, everybody grieves the way they grieve. Everybody grieves different. Everybody goes through emotions different. But, and I wasn't gonna speak on it, but you know, I've had my my comments about it and my thoughts on it. Anyways, I haven't spoken to you guys about it, but of course, you know, like, you know, with, you know, people around my house and my boyfriend and just, you know, different people, we've had this conversation. So I'm gonna come back later, we're gonna get into it, and I just wanna, you know, see what your thoughts are, and I'm gonna just tell you some of the things that I've thought, you know, even though it's really none of our business at the end of the day. But listen, it's in the public, so we're gonna comment, we're gonna, you know, comment about it, not really judge, but we're gonna place our comments and our thoughts. So we're gonna get into that a little bit later, but let me just focus on this road so I can get to where I need to go safely and try to get the heck out of this traffic. I hope it's cleared up by the time I come back down this way. It's nuts. All right, so I'll see y'all shortly. I don't even think I'm even going in the store because I don't want to be tempted at all. I think I'm gonna call that number, do a curbside pickup, and keep it safe so I can be in and out. What's up, y'all? I'm back hours later. So I did get everything that I need for the most part, but today was a wash. It was super weird today. Just weird stuff kept happening. And then on top of that, all of this rain, it's super cold outside again. So we are going to just postpone whatever we're gonna do for his birthday until tomorrow, because we was gonna do a rooftop place and it's just disgusting outside, so that's not gonna work. So we're just gonna chill in the house, relax, and just wait till tomorrow, you know, I guess. But you know, he did get his cake, he has his gifts, so he has those. We're gonna have dinner here and that's about it. And that's his big head right here, all in our camera space.
Happy birthday to me.
Whatever.
Me.
Move.
Today's vlog is about Ace.
It's never about you, boo. It's hey, always
sweetie.
About me.
Hey, sweetie gang.
Woo! He's so annoying. So, yeah, so that's for the, you know, this is what it is today. It's just a wash, you know. It's done. We're going to reset this for tomorrow, okay? So, I'll take you guys along with us. And then tonight is just going to be just quiet time, me and him. And that's it. But guess I'll check in with you guys if not later tonight. No, probably not. I'll see you guys tomorrow, okay? Let me just give you a look over here at his stuff. Hold on. So here we go. His cake, his gifts, card, you know, whatever. Didn't get any balloons. I didn't think that really mattered to him. But the cake is red velvet. I just had it decorated the way I wanted to. And then I want to get into the gifts. That's his business. Maybe I'll show you later. Who knows? But if not, I'll see you guys tomorrow, okay? Be good.
3 days later.
Guys, what's up? Welcome to a new vlog. It is the weekend, Father's Day weekend, as a matter of fact. So shout out to all them fathers out there. For those that are new here, my name is Kinshasha Rhodes, aka Sweet Shashwan. This is a lifestyle channel and we talk about everything. We do a little bit of this, a little bit of that, fashion, food, even finance, relationships, how-to DIYs. You name it, we do it. Nothing is really off limits here. So welcome to the gang. And for all my day ones, thank you for coming back and joining us. Like I said, it's the weekend. Father's Day weekend, as a matter of fact. I don't know what you guys got planned for those deserving fathers out there, but I hope you guys make it special. For me, we'll see. You know, I always got something special or something slick up my sleeve. And also, this week was Ace's birthday. We had a time this week, and I don't mean like in the most positive way. Like, things just didn't work out the way they were planned. So his birthday wasn't what I wanted it to be, but still and yet we did celebrate a little bit. I will put a few clips in of what I tried to do, and then in those clips I'm explaining to you what happened. But anywho, you know, what can we do? Life, right? So we're here. And we'll just try to make the best out of Father's Day, you know? So we'll see. But I'm going to get dressed now, get a quick shower, get all of this together, put my outfit on, come back, and I'm gonna show you guys what I'm gonna wear and what it looks like once I got it together, okay? So I'll be back shortly.
Thank you.
Okay guys, so here's my outfit. I'm gonna pair it with this blazer. There's a one piece jumper that's under it in my favorite colors, green. This comes in other colors too. I will leave the link in the description box for you. I'm gonna pair it here with this pink Gucci belt for the additional pop of colors. I'm gonna pair it with my white and green Stan Smith. I'm just trying to decide whether I want to use these all white laces that come standard with it, or if I wanted to pair with these custom Gucci laces, which has its own print, but I don't mind mixing prints, but it has all the colors that's in the blazer. So I don't know, I'm trying to figure that part out, but we'll see. I'm gonna lace one shoe with one string and the other shoe with the other, just to kind of see how I look, how I like it. I'm gonna play with it a little bit and then decide what I'm gonna wear. Okay, so I will be back. I'm back guys. I just wanted to come on so I can give you a full look of the jumper before I add the blazer to it. I went with the laces with all the colors, and this is the full jumper. Got my 2 cents here. I'm gonna add pretty quick. Wear that all up. Ooh. Okay. So this is it. I'll be back with the full look. Okay guys, here's the full look. The blazer, the jumper, jumpsuit, or whatever you want to call it. The bag, sneakers. Yeah, so this is the look. And I'm going to head out and run my errands.
Have you seen her? It was about 5 minutes ago when I seen her, how the shit got a youngin' never seen before. I say hello, tell the girl I wanna meet her. On second thought, that ain't the way to go. I gotta give her game proper, spit it so she get it. There she is, I gotta stop her. Oh, what about a smile? Oh, what about a smile? She's out the door, I gotta go for a ride. Oh, should I talk about a smile? Oh, I'm out of time. She's out the door, I gotta go for mine. Look like I say, yeah.
Hey guys, so I finally made it out the freaking house. Like, I was really in the house today just recording some extra content to use in other on other social media platform, and it literally takes a long time to like get lighting, get cameras. It takes a lot of work, you know, and especially for people to like reach out to you to do content and ask you to do the content for free. Like, I don't think they get how much work goes into the back end of doing content, especially trying to do really good content for you. And also today my daughter sent me I'm gonna see if I could link it in this vlog if you guys haven't seen it for yourself, where YouTube has now lowered the requirements to become monetized. I'm like, damn, I busted my butt to become monetized, and literally I did it like September, October, November, December, about 3 or 4 months or so. Like 3 months I got it done. I mean, and I bust my tell to get it done at the beginning. I have to get back to that work habit that I had when I first started doing this. I have to get back to that work habit, because that habit was crazy and I really got monetized in within 3 months. But the standards now are low. It's still work, you know, they're still gonna make you work, but it's not as much. It's like almost half of whatever the requirements was for hours, maybe a little less. I'll post a little picture here so you guys could see what it is, but I was like, wow, you know, I busted my butt. So if anyone that's out there that's thinking about it, here's your time to join and start, where for now, while they're not asking for as much requirements to become monetized. So if that's something you guys thinking about, this is a perfect time. So I'm here. I just pulled up to Saks off Fifth. I want to go in to look for something really quick. I have something in particular in mind. If I see it, I'll get it. If not, then it's all right, because I have another luxury unboxing for you guys. I probably will do it sometime this weekend. And I'm looking for something in particular to kind of go with what I have to unbox for you. So we'll do that. And then what else? I have to stop at Five Below to grab something for my son. And that's about it. Like, it's really, really short. It's not like a busy day. And it's going to start back raining again. And I actually want to get in and out before it starts pouring again. So let's get ourselves together and we're gonna head into Saks Off Fifth to see what they got to offer. And then it's called freestyle, fresh paint job, fresh inside. If the outside frame be trunk wide, or the rim thin, do it right, good. Lean back, right hand on the plywood. Cream on the inside, clean on the outside. 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 Ice cream, ice cream, ice cream paint job. Cream on the inside, clean on the outside. Cream on the inside, clean on the outside. Cream on the inside, clean on the outside. Ice cream, ice cream. Clean on the outside, cream on the inside. Ice cream paint job. Got screens on the dash, what can save by the bill. Got a house by the wayside. Yeah, I'm living like that. Sweetie gang, happy Saturday. Let's just start there. I'm not even going to tell you how late in the evening it is now from when I first woke up this morning and was recording with you guys. It's been a day. As a matter of fact, it's been a week. This week, I feel, has been super off. Just odd things, just vibes. I don't know. I just wasn't myself. I didn't feel like myself. Like, the aura around me just didn't feel good. It was just one thing after another. This week, you know, nothing like life shattering or earth shaking. Just little things, you know, nothing to cry about, nothing to spill, you know, spill the milk over or anything like that. It was just weird shit. You know what I mean? So I woke up this morning, you know, I had to run an errand early. I came back in, you know, started getting the house situated and getting something to eat. And then I burnt my sage or whatever, which I showed you guys in the clip. And then I had planned, I got a shower, then I was going to come to you guys and do a, get ready with me, or just a quick like how to with an outfit that I was going to put on. And I was going to show you a few ways to wear it and a few other shoes that you could wear with it, give you some options. My iron didn't work. So I'm like, okay, let me get my steamer. Steamer didn't work. I mean, it was shooting water from across the room. Then, so I was trying to get the water calm and it wasn't overfilled with water. Then I proceeded to try to still steam my top. It soaked my top. So now I'm hot. I cut on my fan because it's like medium here. It's not hot, it's not cold. You know, I have that big glass window in my room and in my living room, so I open up my windows, a nice breeze comes in, so I do use my fan. Fan wasn't working. But even before that, before I figured out those items wasn't working, I was looking for the remote to my camera, couldn't find that, and I knew damn well that I remember putting it in my bag yesterday when I got out of my car. Nevertheless, I ended up finding it. I left it in the car. Then the fan started working, but it was like doing this, I don't know, this dial-up type of movement, and it started working. So that was the start of my day. So it did not like go well. I was super aggravated just with the little things that was going on around me. Of course, all the little things that was going on this week and all the rain that kind of screwed up, you know, some of my plans, but whatever. So I pulled it together. I had to go out anyways because I needed a new iron, and I was also looking for like another floating shelf to put in my closet or somewhere in my room because I need it for my shades. You know, it's shade season. We got a ton of them, and we got them like up in a bag in the closet, and I was like, I need to be able to just grab them and go when I'm looking for them. So I'm standing on a stool, you know, I'm butt so high, you know, short as I don't know what, and trying to reach up and always climb on something to get something I just don't want to do. So I was like, let me just try to get that. At least if I have to climb up, I can climb up, grab what I need, not climb up, bring this heavy bag down, dig through it, try to find the pair that I want to wear for the day, and then climb up, put it back up. I don't want to do all of that. So we're going to get that shelf up tonight. I'm also going to do a quick cook with me with you guys. I have a new like burger gadget that I want to share with you, so I'm gonna do that. You know, I'm a gadget girl, so I want to share that with you. So I'm gonna make some homemade turkey burgers tonight. And what else? Oh yeah, the item, if you watch my vlog from earlier this week, I was telling you about something that I bought and I was excited about, you know, whatever, I got it. So before we get to that, I want to share with you I want to share with you something else, but give me 1 second, okay? I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back. Sorry about that. So I wanted to start with one pair of shoes that I purchased. I got them from Vestor Collective. They are a pre-love site. Now, some pre-loves do have pre-love things. Some of them have brand new things that they want and they just never wore it. It was too small or whatever the reason, and they're it's like a reseller, right? So whenever I do go and look at those items, if there's something that I've wanted and it's new and it's like way less than the original cost, then I'm jumping on it. So these are a pair of shoes that I wanted for a while. I didn't get the color that I originally wanted, but I did settle for this color because I do love the color. If I can get the box open. What does it say? Thanks for helping us make fashion live forever. This is the inside of the box. This is what it comes with. Okay. So it is a luxury item that I'm doing this unboxing with. And of course, it is Gucci. Okay. So here they go. the cement grain. I don't know what is coming off in the camera, but it is a mint grain. These are the mules. These are a few seasons older, but I wanted them forever and I wasn't able to get them. The sizes was out, the colors wasn't around, and they still make this mule, but they make it in a different style now. But these are so gorgeous. The camera's probably not doing as much justice. Now, the only thing that I wish is that I got the higher heel, right? So it's a chunky heel, some are higher. I think I have probably the lowest one, and then they're probably flats, right? So these are it, as you see, brand spanking new. I'll put the site down in the description box if you guys want to ever check them out. There are, like I said, a pre-love or resell site, such as like Fashion Files, Rebag, The Real Real, any of those websites are a good place to look for resold items that sold out. Vintage items are a hit in those places, especially if it's like Louis Vuitton or anything like that. Like, they have the best vintage items. I promise you, Louis Vuitton, I really like the vintage items more than some of the newer things, because the quality is different. It's more longevity, it seems like, with the quality that they had like years ago versus now. So I do like a lot of Louis Vuitton vintage from those sites, because that's where you're gonna go and find them, because you really can't find them in the store, and you can find them sometimes at really good prices. It just depends. Even like Chanel's, I mean, if you want a Chanel's, this could be 10 racks at the store. But if you can go to a reseller that may resell the bag, whether it's older, you, I don't mind doing a resell bag. I just don't want nobody's resold shoes. But bags, you might could get something that the store doesn't have anymore, and it could be a year or two old. Chanel never goes out of style, and you can get some and save you a couple of coins. So a reseller or a pre-love site is always a good place to start. I know Poshmark is a place where some people shop at. It's the only thing about Poshmark, they don't have an authenticity team. I'm not sure. I know these, they authenticate these to make sure that they are real before they sell them to you. I know Fashion File, I bought things from The Real Real. They authenticate it from the jump. Like, they don't even sell it if it's not authenticated before they put it out. This place, however, they charge you $15 to get it authenticated to make sure that it passes everything. You can opt in or opt out for that. But, you know, if you're spending some coins on something that's supposed to be authentic, you should get it authenticated. And as well as, like, this right here comes with this label. And the label just pretty much saying, thank you for creating Future of the Fashion with us. And pretty much saying, like, please only remove this label if you're satisfied. Like, so I can literally take these shoes, go to a Gucci store somewhere and get them authenticated if I wanted to. But I would keep this tag on them until I just double check. Like, I went through the authentication process with them. You can go to the store and do it as well. And once I decide that I want to keep them, then you remove this tag. Fashion File is like that too. Once you remove the tag, it's yours. But for whatever reason, I decide that I don't want these, I don't want to keep them, I can return it as long as this tag is on. But if I was to take it to a store and the store say these are not authentic pair of shoes, then I can return it with or without the tag on. They automatically take it as long as they get the paperwork from the store, right? So Like I said, I do love these. Love the color. I'm just gonna like pretty much like style them with something, because like I said, I wish the heel was a little higher. The ones that I originally wanted were the silver with the sparkle, like silver in it, or like the gold silver, like the gold glitter in it. Let me show you a picture. Hold on one second again. I'm back. My camera was overheating. So I pulled up the shoe. I pulled it up in actual, the gold color. This is not the color that I want. I'll show you the silver one too, but it's a really good picture of the heel. So this is the shoe right here. You can see it. And this is the heel compared to this heel. See? Mine is a little chunkier. This is a little, it's chunky, but it's longer. That's the size heel that I wish I had. But these are probably going to be more comfortable to walk in. I said, like, I'm going to style it up with something and figure it out. But I love the color. And the silver ones, that was the gold. And they came in a ton of colors. This is now what the mules kind of look like. Let me show you. And it's just like a regular heel now. There's no, see, it's kind of, these are, oh no, they do have the chunky heel. I'm lying. Hold on. Let me show you what the chunky heel looks like now. First, let me show you the silver ones. These are the rose gold. Beautiful. Hold on. This is the rose gold. Here, can you see it? Yeah, that's the rose gold color that I really liked. And then the silver was my first choice. And then they came in like pink and navy blue and black, but they were more like a suede material. So I didn't want that because this is like an open toe sandal. I'm only gonna wear it in months like this. So I didn't want a suede shoe to wear in the summer. Even though it's like fuchsia pink, they were pretty colors, but just not my choice. Okay, here are the silver ones right here. You can see them. See, the heel is insane. It's so sickening. The silver ones were beautiful. They're like a glitter. That was my first choice. And as a matter of fact, these are on the same site that I bought these from. But of course, they are a 6.5. So that's too small, especially with these shoes. So, okay. So that's one thing. Let's get to the second item. I showed you guys on Sunday the slides that I bought. Oh, here we go. I had to reorder them, but this time I had to go to Saks because MCM website had sold out of my size. It's not as fancy as the one that you get from MCM, just a black box that I'm saying, you know, thank you card. So here they are. So we're going to try these on and hope that the size is bigger. The print is dumb small on these. I don't know. These are still out for debate. So let's see if this size fits better. These shits are made super small. Because look, once again, barely fits. I mean, it fits, but like barely. The hell? I don't know, guys. We're going to have to see about these. Because I went up a whole size and it's still like right there. Let me just double check the size. I know they say they run small, but darn. I'm going to see what store has it because I'm going to like actually walk in the store and try these on. Yeah, they run small. So we'll see because it's just like a perfect fit. So I don't know. I may or may not keep them. I don't know. And it comes, of course, with the dust bag and what have you. So, I don't know. The jury is out on these at this point. This is going to be the third pair. The first pair, of course, it was my size, but they were way too small. Then I went back in and bought them from the website. And I put them in the cart. They took everything, but then they refunded me because they said they were sold out. And I did notice when I was buying them, it said it was two available. So I guess someone bought those two at the same time and they just beat me to it, I guess. And then this is the third, is the charm. So I'm not sure what's going to happen with that. And then my other thing that I'm super excited about, that I was waiting to get last week, but I just got it today. sticker in this box. It is from Amazon, okay? Ta-da-da-da! You guys are probably not gonna be excited about this like I am. Like I said, I love my gadgets, so I'm super excited. And I got a drone. Yes, it's a drone. I am trying to capture better pictures in areas that I can't reach with my phone, using it for vacation and just different things, just something different to kind of bring to my page. And I feel like the drone is gonna give me the extra splah that I need, right? I'm gonna get some good footage with this joint if I don't crash her. I bought a cheap one to start out with just to learn how to drive her. And then we're gonna go from there. So, it comes with the carrying case. And then the drone is super small though. So this is the drone. And this is the controller. And these are extra battery and wings, some extra batteries, and then the manual. So we can see how to fly this drone without killing ourselves or breaking this up. I think I'm gonna have to take this on a test drive. The motto. Okay, we're gonna see. Yeah, this is the controller. Your phone goes and goes on. The phone goes in this area, and they sent me the wrong color. So I'm going to return this and get the right color. This is not the color I wanted. I wanted the white one. So, goes on. So, okay, it goes like this. And then I guess when you're flying it, you'll be able to see all the footage that you're getting on your phone, and the phone is recording it. So yeah, I'm super excited about this one. I can't wait. Of course, I'll take you guys along with me to see it. So, okay, it's super light. It's lighter than I thought. Maybe because it's a cheaper one. Okay, I'm gonna figure this out tonight. But my camera is overheating again. So I'm going to go into the kitchen and I'm gonna start my turkey burgers. I'll see you guys over there. Let me just clean up this mess, okay? I have to put my paper down. Right here, and then this is my little gadget that I was telling you guys about. It'll be linked below, don't worry, got you. And it shows you how to make like the perfect burger. So like, you take your burger, make them into, put them in like a meatball. Okay. You're gonna take it and you're gonna smash. You're gonna pick it up and you have like the perfect shape patty, right? For homemade burgers, right? So we're just gonna slide it off and place it. Voila. So, let's see if you slide it over so you can see. And there it goes. Another one. I hope you guys can hear me. I feel like I'm talking low. See, here it goes. You don't have to make them this big, but I'm making them pretty big. Place it and smash. You're gonna break it up. Once again, we got the perfect patty. Side it off and place it.
Step back. So I made 8 perfect shaped patties, and I'm going to caramelize some onions, and I'll show you that too. I'll be back. Thank you. to the kitchen. Thank you. Okay, y'all, that about do it. I'm about to have Ace clean the grill for me. I'm gonna enjoy my burger and I will see you guys in the morning.
Good morning. Welcome to a new vlog. Happy Sunday. Let me close these cabinets back here. Happy Father's Day. Shout out to all my fathers or baby zaddies. That's short for them kids, but no, real. Happy Father's Day to all you good fathers out there and deserving fathers. Shout out to you guys today. Make it all about you. Another thing, you see I'm in the lab. I am about to make a brunch, little Father's Day brunch, do my little thing. I'm gonna make some creamy cheese grits, my French toast that you know I told you guys about from Trader Joe's, some candied turkey bacon, hash browns, and Mexican style scrambled eggs, and of course we're gonna have a little mimosa and things like that. So I'm about to get into that. I just wanted to come and give you guys a quick shout out before I get started. I'm trying to decide whether I'm gonna vlog this part or not. I don't know. My camera is about to start overheating. These lights are strong. So give me a second and I'll be right back with you guys, okay?
Cups of the rosé, bitches in my whole phone. I should call one and go home. I've been in this club too long. The woman that I would try is happy with a good guy. But I've been drinking so much that I'ma call her and you'll say, fuck that nigga that you love so bad. I know you still think about the times we had. I'll say, fuck that nigga. See all of her friends here. She don't have the time to kick it no more. Flights in the morning, but you doing that so at all. I've been drinking so much, I'ma call you anyway and say, fuck that nigga that you love so bad. I know you still think about the times we had. I say, fuck that nigga.
And we can ride the boogie, share that beat of love. I wanna ride.